Hey, hi. Greetings this afternoon. What an honor to see you today as we continue with our midweek series, as we dwell deeper in the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we hope that this series will be edifying as we seek to understand the theological meanings of the death and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. And last week we started by asking ourselves a question. Was it necessary for the Lord Jesus Christ to die on the cross? And we came up with four reasons. And the first reason was it was God's eternal purpose that Jesus Christ dies on the cross. And so that is why it was necessary for him to die. And the second reason was God was demonstrating his righteousness. Now, the debt of sin needed to be paid for. And so that is why the Lord Jesus Christ had to die on the cross. And thirdly, we needed a high priest. Because we know that it was the work of the high priest to take the sacrifice to the Holy of Holies, we needed a better high priest. And so Jesus Christ became the faithful and merciful high priest. And the fourth reason was the blood of bulls and goats was not sufficient to take away our sin. So it was necessary for the Lord Jesus Christ to die. And so today we look at something that is equally interesting. And we will be looking at what it meant for Jesus Christ to go through the pain that he went through on the cross. And we are going to be looking at the many aspects of the pain on the cross. Now, the pain, the crucifixion was one of the most vicious and horrible forms of execution that man ever invented. And we can look at the pain that the Lord Jesus Christ went through as one big thing, but it would be important for us to look at this pain in many aspects just to appreciate the intensity. And so we're going to be looking at the four aspects of the pain of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. And so this is the first aspect, his physical pain and death. When you imagine what it meant for someone to be crucified and their arms or their hands were outstretched and they were fastened by nails on both ends. And the same as the feet, they were fastened by a nail. And what it meant for anyone who was crucified to breathe was that a lot of pressure would be exerted on the feet and also on the hands. And that means the hands would rotate around the nail. And so it was such a difficult process to breathe because it was really, really, really painful. And so many criminals would actually die through suffocation because of how difficult it was for them to breathe. And you do not want to forget the pain on the back because of the lashes of the whips. So there was a lot of physical pain that was involved in death on the cross by the Lord Jesus Christ. The second aspect of the pain that the Lord Jesus Christ went through is the emotional pain of bearing the sin. Now, we all have sinned and we know how guilty it we know how bad it feels when you sin. You know the guilt and the shame that gets into us, and when you think about a sin you have committed, you don't get a good feeling. And now imagine the Lord Jesus Christ, who did not have a sinful nature like us. He hated sin so much, and you can imagine him being associated with sin. You can imagine all our sins together placed on him who knew no sin, placed on him who was righteous and perfectly holy. Just imagine how painful it was emotionally. And the Bible tells us so in Isaiah 53 verse 6, that the Lord had laid on him the iniquity of us all. As 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, "For our sake he made him to be sin who knew no sin." So the Lord Jesus Christ did not know sin, and all the sin was placed on him, and you can imagine the emotional pain that was caused. Actually, Galatians 3:13 also adds and says, "Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us." This was heavy emotional pain. The third aspect of pain that the Lord Jesus Christ went through was abandonment. Jesus Christ bore this pain alone. He was alone on the cross. He was alone as he groaned with pain. He was having to go through this painful process on his own. And the Bible says in Mark 14:34, he shared with his disciples, the few that were with him. And he said to them, "My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch." So Jesus Christ really needed some company. He needed people to be close to him. But Matthew 26:56 shows us how he was abandoned. The Bible says after his betrayal and arrest, the Bible shows us that all the disciples left him and fled. So you can imagine the kind of abandonment that the Lord Jesus Christ went through. And that was another aspect of the pain that he suffered. And so the fourth aspect of the pain that the Lord Jesus Christ suffered was bearing the wrath of God. Now, as if all the other forms of pain were not enough, he faced the wrath of his very own father. And when you imagine the kind of weight that would mean, knowing who God is, you can imagine the vengeance against sin, the hatred that God had against sin from the time that the earth began, from the beginning of the world, all through to the time that the Lord Jesus Christ was being crucified. All that wrath, the accumulation of all that wrath, is what the Lord Jesus Christ had to contend with. Now, some of us have faced the wrath of our human fathers. And it's a bad thing to be in conflict with your father. It's a bad thing to be punished by your father. It's a bad thing to face the anger of your dad. Now, this is a human father who is also a sinner and who has his own limitations. Now, think about a God who is infinite, a God who is holy, a God whose might and strength cannot be comprehended by mere mind and mere knowledge. Think about how mighty God is. Think about his wrath being placed upon you. And then you can appreciate the kind of wrath that the Lord Jesus Christ had to face and to contend with. And so may these aspects of pain, you know, remind you today that the Lord Jesus Christ, you know, paid the price for you, and he bore your sins through a very excruciating and painful experience. And so may this knowledge of knowing the pain that the Lord Jesus Christ went through serve as a platform for inviting those who do not know the Lord Jesus Christ. Because nobody wants to face God on their own. Nobody wants to face this wrath on their own. And that's why the Bible says in Hebrews 10:31 that it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. It's a fearful thing when you imagine facing God's wrath. And you can see what the Lord Jesus Christ did for you. He faced that wrath on your behalf. And so all we need to do is, you know, respond to this work that the Lord Jesus Christ did in faith. All we need to do is respond to what the Lord Jesus Christ did in repentance. And then we will be safe from this wrath. And so may this be a call to those who take the death of Jesus Christ for granted, to look at these four aspects and say, indeed, Christ suffered for me. And I do not want to suffer for myself when Christ actually did it for me. And our suffering for ourselves would not achieve for us any salvation, because our offense is too great, and so we would have to suffer forever. But the Lord Jesus Christ, being a righteous sacrifice, came and suffered, died on the cross, so that we would not have to be punished. So would you come to Christ, you sinner, you who has never turned to the Lord Jesus Christ in faith? Would this be a platform of invitation? Would this be a call for you, you know, to take careful thought to your ways and realize that there is no other way out. There is no escape route apart from the Lord Jesus Christ who died for us. So I wish you well and God bless you. Let us pray. Our loving Father, we pray that you would continue to strengthen us and help us to comprehend with humility and with awe the price and the weight of the things that the Lord Jesus Christ did for us, so that we would be saved. And so we ask you to continue helping us to comprehend with commitment what it meant for the Lord Jesus Christ to die for us. And so, Lord, we pray that when we see the pain that he went through, that our lives would be challenged and we would even more zealously work out our salvation with fear and trembling. We thank you, Lord, and this we pray in Jesus' name. I wish you well. God bless you. I'll see you next week, Lord willing. Amen.